The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Welcome back. We are almost there. Oh my God, we're doing 19 through 1. I am so glad that we're almost there, man. Tell you what, I'm hot. I'm burning up. It's crazy. Figured we're in this stuff like that, but man, that's crazy. So this is our last final destination. Celebrity drawings. Again, I want to thank people that's helped me out. Brett, for being my co-host for one show. Vicious Venom. I kind of knew what your intentions were. Challenging me to a match. It's okay. The match is still going to go on, but I don't thank my crew again for showing up. Deb, Paul, Wesley. If you guys weren't able to do this, it wouldn't happen. Thank you guys very much. But yeah, after I get done with number one, I got an announcement I want to make. So here we go with number 19. Yeah, I know it needs oil for sure. Wesley's mom like, it needs oil. I was like, yeah, for sure. Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins got to do a wrestling entrance here in Fort Wayne. Not only did he do the wrestling entrance, but he got to sign JJ and Brett's cell phone. I don't know if Brett remembers that or not. But number 19 is Seth Rollins signing the phone for the boys at the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum. So roll that footage. Seth Rollins signing the phone for my boys in his entrance. Roll that footage.
Thank you. 17 pounds, Seth freaking we
Daddy!
nightmare, Cody Rhodes. The main event is coming up next. It's going to be amazing. I just wanted to take 2 seconds to let you all know how much I appreciate you following me, and those who didn't follow me, those who are welcoming me back home, thank you guys very, very much. And I would be remiss if I did not point out that in the crowd tonight is the band Downstate. They're sitting right over here. These are the guys, yeah, these are the guys who have made my music, and that music has been played everywhere. Round of applause for Downstate, baby! Thank you guys, enjoy the main event. I sincerely mean it, I love you all very much. Have a great night, be safe, thank you.
We are back. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that, man. Like I said, it's full of wrestling, musicians, actors, and whatever, man. Yeah, so far some of the newest interviews, like Johnny Fairplay hasn't made it yet. Neither has Sage Karam. So hopefully some of these new ones get it. Who's going to be number one? I don't know, man. We're getting close. We're getting close. Heck, the Boyz II Men cameos didn't even make it. So who will be number 18? Some of these just want to pop out and just go. Number 18 is Jim Cornette. Oh my God, that video was classic. So the gist of the interview, we just did an interview with Jim Cornette, and next thing you know, now this is the number 2 viewed video on my YouTube channel, Landis Entertainment Network. And Teddy Long comes in and interrupts, which is not planned. So this is one of my favorite interviews, and I said it's number 2 on the most watched videos on my YouTube channel. So, ladies and gentlemen, here is the Jim Cornette and Teddy Long interview at Heroes and Legends. So, roll that footage of the classic interview with Jim Cornette and Teddy Long. So, roll that footage back there. Welcome to Heroes and Legends. Here I am, your host, Jeff Landis, along with.
What? You're not going to give me a big introduction? I wrote it out for you and everything. Oh, what's the matter? I paid you $6. To say this. Jim Cornette, pro wrestling legend, friend to furry woodland creatures, the star of the show today, Heroes and Legends, Fort Wayne, the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum. We are cooking today.
Yeah, he's taking over. So what do you got planned tonight? I heard that you got a Q&A. What can you give us a little example of what you're going to do tonight, or what's going on?
Well, it's 5 o'clock, and I'm going to be answering questions, hence the Q part and the A part. They Q and I A, and you can expect the unexpected, because any question that I get asked, I will answer it. If I don't want to answer your question, I'll just answer a different question.
It will turn on you. Now, speaking of that, you got your own podcast as well. Tell a little bit about your podcast.
Well, I got a couple of them. The Jim Cornette Experience drops, as the children say, every Thursday, where I talk about a little bit of everything. And then Corny's Drive-Thru, where the viewers get to ask their questions, drops every Monday. And I do the same thing. I promulgate and disseminate my wisdom to the masses.
Wow, he's always got a lot to say. He never holds back. I've seen a lot of your shoot promos.
Well, I'm holding back right now. I'd like to punch you right in the mouth, but I'm holding back.
Anything.
I'm a friend of mine. Yeah.
I hope so.
Give me $6 back. See? They love me here in Fort Wayne.
For sure. For people that's ever met Jim Cornette for the first time, what do you want to say to people that's never seen you in person?
For people that have never met me before and are meeting me for the first time, bring money.
It's true. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for...
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and children of all ages. Come on out to the Heroes and Legends event at the War Memorial Coliseum in Fort Wayne. As you can tell, there's already a massive audience here and even more waiting to see you. We want to see your face in the place. My heavens, it's Theodore.
Oh, hey, how's it going, Taylor? How are you?
I'm doing good. I just wanted to come in and say hello to my friend Jim Cornette. I don't know you, so I don't really care.
Oh.
I love you, Theodore.
Hey. I love you, too. I'm messing with you,
Blair. Cool.
You got a little something on your eye right there.
Oh,
man.
I got a skin tag.
It's called his face.
Skin tag.
They're looking for a cure for that face, but they haven't come up with one so far.
You're in good shape for Halloween, Blair.
But in parting, Jeff, me and Teddy Long would both like to wish everybody out there in your audience love, peace, and soul.
So come out, Heroes and Legends. Like I said, Teddy Long is here. So anything you want to say to the fans coming out here tonight?
I just want to say come on out and spend some money. Holla.
It's all about the dollar and the holla.
We're so money-oriented. We're capitalists. We're capitalists here.
Well, we got to have it. I tell you what, you try living without it.
You know, Teddy, my wife is so ungrateful. I fed her yesterday. Turned around today, she wants to eat again.
Wow. You better get a divorce.
Thanks, Jeff.
Teddy. No problem.
Come on, player. Let's talk.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you never know what to expect at Heroes and Legends. See you guys later. We are back. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that interview. I did too. Everybody's on Facebook. Oh, they were making fun of you. Like, I know they're doing their stick. They're doing their thing. They're having fun. You know, yeah, they made fun of me, but again, it's professional wrestling. You got to take the jabs to get into it, man. Again, yeah, I had a good time, man. It's like one of my interviews where, because legit, I was like, oh, wow, and then they interrupted. So it's, yeah, it's one of those things that you can't predict, but it happens. So number 17. Who's going to be number 17? Ah. Roadblock. That's not number 17, but Roadblock was in my way. Can't wait to, after this, I'm no longer going to be doing any more lottery drawings for after this. Number 17 is Santino Marella. We got to interview him at Heroes and Legends, and got to also interview him at Wrestling for Warriors. So you guys remember Santino Marella? He's also in TNA right now, so yeah. So Santino Marella is number 17. So roll that footage of Santino and I.
The last season for Dos Landis, and I had him on the first season. I'm sure he doesn't remember that because you travel everywhere. So you're here in Fort Wayne. What do you got planned here for? I mean, you just did a seminar.
Yeah, just a seminar. We're here at the convention, and there's over 500 people coming here today. There's tons of superstars. Actually, if you're seen this before, you know, the other one's going to air, but I'd come down.
Oh, it's going to air tonight.
Oh, right on. Yeah, come on down. There's a match tonight, and it's a good time, but for the love of wrestling.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Now, you've been in Fort Wayne, and you've had tons of members here in Fort Wayne. What do you think about Fort Wayne?
I love Indiana. I live in Louisville, just across the border. We come wrestle up in southern Indiana. But I've always had great times. And the people of Indiana, they really always made me feel really welcome and at home. In fact, when I wrestled in Indiana back in the day, it always felt like a hometown crowd.
We got tons of great fans here. No matter where you go, Louis, you know, everywhere in the game. You know, so thank you for coming here. Thanks for being on the show.
Oh, thank you.
Oops, oh.
Sorry.
We are back. Number 16 is getting closer. It's getting closer. Some of these people have made it. Some of these people haven't. It's been majority of professional wrestlers. Again, you notice that always happens with me, don't you? Professional wrestling always happens. Maybe it's my calling because everybody's like, well, Jeff, you know, you should just go back to wrestling. Maybe it is my calling. I mean, you never know. You never know. Number 16. Number 16. Genuine. In those jeans. Riding my pony. So Genuine came to Fort Wayne. I was trying to get an interview with him, but his agent didn't get a hold of me. But my cousin Kirsten got video footage of him at Headwaters Park performing. So, ladies and gentlemen, you enjoy some R&B music from Genuine at Headwaters Park. So, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy this music, R&B music from, enjoy the music from Genuine. So, roll that footage. Things have changed. Technology is crazy. So right now we're doing things off my phone. So this is raw footage right now. But again, I said I'm gonna work on some new stuff. So we gotta get this stuff done. We gotta do what we gotta do. So we're at number 15 for the top celebrity drawing. So we're gonna hurry up and do this fast because we gotta do what we gotta do. Plus I don't know about the storage. Things happen. Life's unpredictable. Gotta get things done. So we're gonna be doing drawing number 15. Genuine was number 16, so we're doing number 15. What's it gonna be? Number Jimmy Jacobs is number 15. We had to interview Jimmy Jacobs at Wrestling for Warriors. I was actually a manager for him. As a matter of fact, I'm going to show the match. I'm going to show the match with me and Jimmy Jacobs as well.
Make sure you keep it that way.
Wrestling for Warriors. And then also one I got to manage him.
Welcome to Adosa Landis. Here I am, your host, me, Jeff Landis. You know, it's kind of familiar. I managed this guy back in 2000-something against Jake.
Who knows when?
You fought Doink the Clown.
Doink the Clown?
You guys are the main event.
I got problems with everybody, apparently.
We're here in Fort Wayne, Indiana. What's going on?
With the zombie princess, Jimmy Jacobs. You have to introduce to me, otherwise people don't know who I am.
Sorry.
Yeah, I mean, if I wasn't me, I wouldn't know who I am either, so it's fine. You have to say, it's Jimmy Jacobs.
And I go,
oh, yes, I'm a princess. You know, that's
sorry.
That's the bet. No apologies needed. That's all.
So yeah, we're here in Fort Wayne.
We are here in Fort Wayne. The Warriors for Wrestling, co-promoted with the House of Hardcore tonight. And I have a lot of fans around here and meeting the wrestlers. That's sort of intimate nature of independent wrestling. It's real nice.
Yes, and you're king of independent. You've been around.
I'm the princess of independent wrestling. Thank you. Okay.
Sorry. It's been forever since I've worked with you.
It was an easy one. Yeah.
But yeah, you're here tonight. You're also managing Congo Kong, and you've known Congo Kong for a long
20 years. I've known Congo Kong 20 years. You know, I broke into the business in 99, but I was like hanging around the business like 98, and that's when I met Congo Kong. I've known Congo Kong longer than I've known anybody else in the wrestling business.
Nice. And he's got a match with Moose tonight. Any, yep. Anything going on? You got anything planned?
Everything's going on. I've got all sorts of plans, but I can't tell you. I can't tell you what the plans are. You'll have to see the plans unfold. You know, that's like a good strategist.
Oh yeah, Jimmy's a mastermind.
I guess so. Yeah,
for sure. Well, yeah, this has been Dos Orlandis with Jimmy Jacobs.
All right. Cheers. Thank you, my man.
It's been forever since I've worked with him back in EWF days. As a matter of fact, I got that match somewhere.
Oh, jeez.
So, all right. See you guys later.
Thank you.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed that footage. So again, like I said, number 15 is Jimmy Jacobs. So like I said, we have to change things around. Have to do it this way. Sometimes you got to do what you got to do in entertainment. Technology is a pain, so got to keep going because things got people got appointments, people got to take care of stuff. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do number 14 of the drawing. Oh, it just fell out. This time you get to actually see the extreme close-up. So Earl Hebner. We got to interview Earl Hebner at Heroes and Legends. Yeah, I'm also writing down a thing, so you know what's what. We got to interview Heroes and Legends, and we got to talk about him refereeing and doing a referee roundtable. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's the interview with Earl Hebner. What's wrong with Earl Hebner? How's it going?
It's going great, man.
Man, it's been a while since I've seen you, like, back in 2005.
Well, you just ain't been in the right place, man. I've been around for a long time.
Oh, yeah, I know that. Like I said, you're hardly in Fort Wayne anymore because you're everywhere. So, what are you doing here at Heroes and Legends?
Well, I'm doing some autographs. With AWA.
Sweet. Anything you can tell your fans out there? I mean, you're one of the best referees known. I've been in the refereeing business since 2002, thanks to Jason Maples, the promoter here tonight. What kind of advice could you give somebody like me who's been in the business forever? Because I know you never stop learning.
You know, you never stop learning. I'm still learning. It's something that is really difficult. People think it's easy, but it's not. You know, but the ones that want it have to work for it. In this business, nothing's free.
That's true.
So it's either you make it or break it.
That's true. Now, I with my TV show, I've always wanted to do, because you always see on the network and anywhere else, they see the big name wrestlers being interviewed for a roundtable. As a referee, I would like to see a referee roundtable. I mean, I would love to have you on, Jeff Doan on, Justin King, just a whole bunch of good professional referees on. What do you think? Do you think somebody should do something like that?
I think so.
A roundtable?
Yeah. I mean, you know, we're not a wrestler, but we rule what's in the ring.
Yeah, people forget that there's three of us.
Exactly.
In the ring, because we are also the storytellers as well as the wrestlers as well.
Right.
I want to say thank you very much for everything you've done for me. You inspired me to being a professional referee, and it means a lot to me, and I'm glad to have you on the show.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
We're back. Again, like I said, this is raw footage, but this will be edited, so I understand we got to do what we got to do. And being in entertainment for long, you gotta do what you gotta do. So, ladies and gentlemen, number 13 is going to be. Who's it gonna be? Special shout out to my son for being an MVP for doing my phone camera. Number. Trevor Murdoch. Let's see it right there. Trevor Murdoch at Smash Fest. So roll that footage of Trevor Murdoch at Smash Fest. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm always on. It's got to be fucking big. Yeah.
Number 12. What's it going to be? Number 12 is going to be, digging deep into it. Sorry, I'm sweating. I'm nervous about today right now. It's Danny Trejo. We got to interview Danny Trejo at DeadCon. He's one of the interviews that we didn't think we were going to get, but he's definitely a legend in acting. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's Danny Trejo, number 12. Let's go to number 11. What is number 11 going to be? Danny Trejo. Hello, here I am, Jeff Anderson with Danny. How's it going?
Great. Love being here.
So, how do you enjoy Fort Wayne so far?
You know what? Just awesome. Everybody's been real friendly, smooth, and it's pretty good for, like, the first... You know, it's well organized, so whoever did it is doing a good job.
Oh, yeah, Eric Vernon did a really good
Eric,
job.
Yeah.
I noticed that you got a huge fan base. How does it feel being here in Fort Wayne with a fan base?
Hey, they're great, and it's, wow, I got a big fan base. That's awesome.
No, you never know until you meet these fans, because, like I said, I've been doing TV since I was 14 years old, and it makes you feel good. It's like that drug, because you want to keep going and going and going.
Love them, love them. Yeah, so we had a great Q&A, and we just had a lot of fun. Me, Foresight, and new kind of.
That's awesome. Again, like I said, anything you say to your fans out here in Fort Wayne, because we got one more day with you here as well.
Yeah, I'll see y'all on Sunday, man. Get down here. God bless you.
Thank you for watching Dust Landers. Thank you very much for your time.
Number 11. What is number 11 going to be? Danny Trejo. See, these things keep popping out. Number 11 is Bobby Lashley. His entrance here in Fort Wayne, Indiana for WWE. Okay, there we go. Who's number 10 gonna be? Oops. We'll do it that way. They just both popped out, so number 10 is gonna be L.A. Knight. He did a promo here in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Before he became popular, and they were talking about the draft. So L.A. Knight is number 10.
I like that. I like that a lot. I like that a lot to yourself right now, too. You feel the charm of this world. It's feeling the cabota of L.A. Knight. Why is that? Because 2023 was my year, and 2024, damn sure you made it different.
Yeah!
But you got to know this. As sure as Jimmy Uso just got put through this table, slapped on his head, and a big old owl for his troubles, you got to know that that's coming to Roman Reigns real soon.
Yeah!
Just let me go ahead and say, I hear all of you. I see all of you. Most of you out here, like I said, feel the provoker. There's a couple of you that can't figure it out just yet. But let me put it to you this one. I ain't gonna come out here and ask you to like me. Bottom line is, I'm not asking you. I'm telling you whose game this is without everybody to say.
Yeah!
Hey! Let me talk to you. Standing here in Fort Wayne, Indiana, it's just got me thinking to myself, don't you hear that? It's just got me thinking to myself, the draft's coming up next week, and that's all anybody can talk about, and why? Tell me really why.
Since number 9 wanted to pop out as well, so number 9 is New Kids on the Block. My friend Charlene, she went to go New Kids on the Block concert. I was like, oh, can you send me the video footage? So here is New Kids on the Block, number 9, performing at their anniversary show, I think. And this was from Landis World Order, one of the Landis World Order shows. So roll that footage.
The night is here. Are you ready? For another...
They pop out. Number eight is Zach Call. Zach Call is a part of the group here in Fort Wayne called Downstate. Now, Downstate has wrote the song of Cody Rhodes. He's also a wrestler as well, Zach Call. Mike Bowling got to interview him at the Central Warriors. He was in the Battle Royal. So the gentleman rolled that footage of... Zach Call. Keep going. So we're at number seven.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Bolin for A Dose of Landis, and I am here with Downstate's Zach Call. We're here at Wrestling for Warriors, House of Hardcore, Hardcore for Charity. Zach, you're in the Battle Royal tonight. Do you have some kind of strategy for what you're going to do?
First and foremost, I just want to thank everybody that got me involved with today. It's a great cause. I'm excited to be on the show, excited to be working with some of my icons. My strategy, I'm stronger, faster, just better, survive. I don't know if it's the 90-second intervals or if we're all in there at the same time, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to be the last one in the ring tonight. I'm go on, main event, whatever it is. It's me, baby, all the way. I'm ready to do it. Last second entrant, nobody's got a game plan for me. I'm dangerous.
Now, Zach, if we were going to book you for a professional wrestling event, how would we go about doing that?
You can go through any of my Facebook, any of my social media, get a hold of me that way. We can talk today. Anybody that's here today, I'm very personable. I got a booth set up over here today. Anybody that wants to come talk, meet us out here. Doors open at 4. We're out here till 6. It's really, really easy to book me. We also go through my manager, Chris B. Thoughts. Chris Pressler, he handles all my stuff because when you're as big time as me, you got to go through my manager, actually. So let's go that way because I don't want to hear from everybody right now.
All right, Zach, thank you for your time. You're watching A Dose of Landis, and we're going to have more coming from right here at the Grand Wayne Center.
Number seven, we're getting close. Getting very close. I'm so glad that we're almost done with things. Look at that, I'm sweating bullets. Just sweating bullets. Number seven is going to be popping out the Mean Boys were here in Fort Wayne. They're on Comedy Central. We got to interview Mean Boys. They have their podcast. And the next thing you know, I found out that they're on Comedy Central. Comedy Central. We got to interview them over by my job at J.K. O'Toole or O'Reilly's. Right off right by where I live. It's crazy because they're like right outside where we did the interview. So, pull that footage of Mean Boys.
Our very last segment here I'm along with.
Tom Goss.
Mark McSpadden.
Keith Carey.
Now, tell me a little bit about your podcast. I know I interviewed Tom earlier, but since I got all three of you guys here, tell me a little bit about your comedy history and how you guys came about.
Yeah, it's kind of like a late night show or a sketch show or a morning radio show, but without all the really bad parts. And, we did lots of, it's like if Jimmy Fallon did jokes about ISIS instead of, I don't know.
Ice cream.
Yeah.
Instead of just, remember Saved by the Bell? That's technically a TV show.
What if I sounded like Neil Young, but the song was about butts? Surely this is worth millions of dollars.
Basically, we have an anti-Jimmy Fallon podcast. That's how we sound. Oh, we have fun. We get a little crazy. We have a lot of great fans.
None of them are here tonight.
Oh, no, mercy. No, the worst of Indiana turned out tonight.
Yeah. Yeah, this was like performing in Kenny Chesney's butthole.
Yeah,
what it felt
I've never
like.
Done stand-up in a prisoner of war camp before. This was incredible.
I had fun. I'm used to war.
I was in some kind of like bro purgatory. It was just like the same dude over and over.
That's how this would turn out. But yeah, it's working out fine. So it's crazy on how this thing we're going comedy because number six is Olivia Grace. Me and Kevin York got to interview her at Gutbusters at the time. and come to find out that she also was on Comedy Central. So here's Kevin York with Olivia Grace.
Hey Kevo, welcome back to A Dose of Landis. And who do we have today?
Oh, Olivia Grace. Do you want me to say anything?
Yeah, that's good.
Olivia Grace.
Awesome. So we're here, as you already know, we're at Gutbusters tonight, which is awesome. So where are you from? Just tell me where you're from, a little bit of your background.
I grew up in Southern California.
Okay.
And now I live in Fort Wayne. I've lived in New York over the summer. And I've just been kind of traveling the country, nice. And I decided to live here.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So what other areas have you, like, traveled into
on
your way here?
I did a whole tour of the Midwest this last month. It was, like, February and March, which is apparently a really bad time to drive through the Midwest.
Oh, yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you're at number five. Number five. Who will number five be? San Diego Cirillo. He was also on Walking Dead and other things. We have to interview him at DeadCon as well. He's a really class act. So here is San Diego Cirillo. Roll that footage.
Welcome to Dos Landis. You never know who we're going to interview. Here I am along with
Santiago Cirillo, actor, producer and writer and author and all that nice stuff, especially his show Walking Dead.
So you've been doing it for a while. What made you decide I want to be in The Walking Dead?
Oh, I have an agent. And I've been auditioning a lot, been in the business for about 13 years, but I always wanted to entertain people. I was very much in love with the stage performance. I used to do a lot of stage and acting gigs when I was in high school. I love entertaining people.
It's a drug. I keep telling everybody I've been doing TV since I was 14 here in Fort Wayne. And it's a drug. Especially when you get people like, oh my God, you do good work. I want to come see you. And these meet and greets are definitely awesome as well.
Yeah, it's good to network and show your artwork around to everybody. Everybody has a gift, you know, and you should express it as much as you can.
That is very, very true. You got to make your dreams come true because they can't happen by you sitting on your couch or anything. You got to go for it as well. So everyone says, if I wanted to book you for a convention like today, how do I do that?
I'll just come around to my social media. I respond through social media. And you can go from there. Or Google me up and you can find me.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Anything to say to the fans before we go?
Yeah, live life. Follow your dreams and always be you. Never give up. You can do it. Everybody can do it. Show your talent.
That is very, very true. Stay tuned for more on Dos Landis.
Four to go. One, two, three, four to go. So are you guys ready? Because I'm ready to get this thing done and over with. I'm shaking and nervous. So, a couple of interviews that didn't make it. But I will tell you this. If Johnny Fairplay does not make it on this one, we will be doing another show. Yeah, that's right, Wesley. We'll be doing another show. We'll show Johnny Fairplay's interview if he doesn't meet us as well. So after this, we'll be doing another show. Not today, but down the road, you know what I mean. So number four is Solo Sikoa. So we got to go to WWE, and Solo had to face Cody Rhodes in a match.
Solo!
Can't wait to get this thing over with. Remind me to do this again, Wesley, Brett, whoever is around me. Do not do 50 because 50 drives you crazy because things happen. That's very, very crazy. But you can't tell me anything. But here we go, down to the last three. I know my favorite number seems to be 50, but no more 50s. No more 50 projects after this. It's done sweat me off. I'm sweating so much that I'm going to end up losing weight after this. But here's number three. Number three is... Number three is a pain in the butt. Is Ed Martin and PJ Farley, Mr. Big. We got to interview them. Brett, actually, you were there for that. Remember that? Sweetwater Sound, we got to do an interview with Eric Martin and PJ Farley. Got two big names in one day. PJ Farley is part of Trickster, and Mr. Big is part of Eric Martin. And we're in talks with them right now. So number three is Eric Martin and PJ Farley. We got to interview them at Sweetwater Sound, and they're also going to see them performing To Be With You. Sweetwater Sound. So roll that footage in Landis Entertainment Network. Roll it.
Jeff Landis, along with Ed Martin and Mr. Big. How's it
going? Hey, very good. Have you met my son, PJ Farley, over here from Trickster?
Oh, yeah. Wow, that's cool. Nice to meet interesting.
You. Yeah.
They look like twins, can't you tell?
Yeah, right.
But anyways, tonight we're here at Sweetwater Sound Pavilion. You guys are performing tonight.
Yeah.
How did you guys come about of meeting each other and when they wanted to get together? Because you guys would have been two different bands.
Ironically, we met on... I was on tour with Mr. Big. I was home, and I went to see PJ and the Trickster guys opening to Warrant in my hometown. So that's comes around full circle here, ironically. So, I got to be good friends with everybody in the band, but PJ and I just seemed to kind of click musically. And so when I needed somebody to do my little acoustic thing, which is now it's called Eric Martin's Big Acoustic. And sometimes we do like Eric Martin Trickster. It's hard to explain because we don't have a band name, right? So it's just like, it's Eric Martin and PJ Farley. And it's worked so far. It's done really great.
Sweet. You guys ever thought about putting an album together?
No.
Oh, no? I mean, he's being honest. I mean, that's one thing about
sounds like a lot of work.
Yeah, exactly. This part is supposed to be painless. You know, in our own prospective bands, I mean, that's all the hard work and all that, you know, blood, sweat, and tears and all that stuff. No, man, this is like easy and comfortable to be on the road. I mean, the 6-hour drives,
So, you guys are playing here in Fort Wayne. Is this your guys' first time here in Fort Wayne, or?
Hold on for a minute. Let's do it. Don't worry. Say it again.
Oh, sorry.
But slowly.
Is this your guys'?
Okay, because I'm from Italy.
Okay. Is this your guys' first time here in Fort Wayne performing?
No, I played in Fort Wayne a bunch of times with Mr. Big, but our first...
Together is, together. Yeah, but no, Fort Wayne is basically short
sure, timing.
Fort Wayne is a second home to me. I'm in another band called Ra that is kind of based out of here now. My singer lives here, and it's always been a welcoming town, so to speak.
Gotcha.
So, no, I
just made the deadline on that speech.
Town. Hey, because I know you guys had a long. You guys have been touring like crazy.
Yeah.
Where are you guys going next? I mean, tonight you're here in Fort Wayne. Where else are you guys going?
Actually, we're coming back to Indiana.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, next Wednesday or Thursday, we're in Gibson City, Illinois, with Warren again.
Oh, yeah.
That's Friday. Then but Saturday, Monticello, Indiana. For MoFest with Warren and Firehouse. And then
a lot of times we play in Richmond, Indiana at our friend Tom Broyles' Firehouse.
Come on, man.
Yeah, I'm excited that you guys all think we're coming on the Dos Landis thing to show your fans that's coming out tonight. Sorry, I'm excited. I'm very excited.
So are we.
Get to interview you.
Hey, you're pumping me up a little bit.
I'm trying, man.
I'm just kind of waking up. My throat's waking up. I appreciate all your mojo.
Hey, so I try. I mean, I came in from my job earlier. No, so.
You had me.
I had to, okay.
No need to explain.
You're in what you're
in. You got it.
Sweet. Yeah, by the way, my coworker made this as well. I wanted to show it. She made this, Olivia. Woo-hoo. She made good artwork, so I figured why not make a debut on the show tonight. So tonight, what time did you guys perform?
7 p.m.
7? Really?
7 p.m.?
Gotta warm up.
He's ready. I'm anxious.
Warm up.
This guy. You know, you can't take the little boy out of the animal. You know, I don't know what that means, but this guy has been, you know, just with all the stuff that you heard about Trickster all those years, right?
Yeah.
Party hardy rock and roll guys. Never left. I'm the guy's like, look at him. He looks great for like 75 years old, right?
You can take the animal out of the little boy, though, can't you?
Wait, he was saving that up. No, that's not a closer. God, thank God we're opening because we're not headlining status yet.
We're going to edit that in our time.
We're not going to edit. That's going on the access.
Make it perfect. Right. Make it awesome. Make right. it totally, for sure.
Well, right. Enjoy whatever you're watching and come see us.
Facebook Live and at Dos Landis on YouTube as well. So, yeah, stay tuned for more. Great show. Before we go, anything you guys say to your fans?
Thanks for putting up with us.
Do we still have some fans left? No, well, thanks to each and every one of you for holding the torch up high for all the 80s and 90s rock and roll. That's still, it's been here for a long, long time, but now it's kind of, now that it's become a resurgence in parts of the United States and in Europe, pockets. Bringing a whole new generation to it. And I have spoken. Too much.
No, you're fine. I love the 90s and I love the 80s, man. I tell you, I listen to that all the time. I've got a story to tell you. My favorite song is...
How long was they out, PJ?
Dang, it's like that. Just real quick.
Hold on for a minute. Jeff!
Yeah.
I know him.
Oh, I said it. That was kind of like...
That's not it.
But no, I was listening to Be With You. This was when I was like a middle school kid and some girl was like messing with me on the bus. And I was just anxious how it was my first experience with... With a female was listening to one of your songs to be with you.
Well, that happens, man.
Very romantic.
I'm telling you, I mean, a lot of people got married from it. A lot of people have, a few people have gotten divorced from it.
Oh, well, I know we don't want to go into personal about your life because, again, you're here to entertain. I'm humble. I'm very glad to have you guys on. Thank you very much. Well,
thanks for having us.
We planned this for a couple months.
Yeah.
All right,
guys.
Better watch him if not.
We gotta go do a sound check now. We gotta make sure that we sound reasonably good.
Thank you very much.
California. Three, four!
Welcome to Adult Landis. Here's my special guest this evening is. So, wow, she's hitting on me already. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I don't want to get in trouble. Don't need that. But anyways, we're here at.
You like trouble?
Oh, yeah. I mean, she had the highest rated thing. Actually, I just talked to the photographer about you earlier about the DCW and stuff back in Michigan. So we're here at Heroes and Legends. What do you got for us? And I know you love the fans. But...
They're fun. Bunch of ECW ones, most of my like popular outfits, and of course this one. I always say this one. It looks like I spent time in jail because.
Oh, I did not notice.
I just noticed that too. I was like, wait, is this where I spent time in jail with the numbers here? But now we have the. Light me out once. I get to fly around.
Oh yeah, that's right, you're in WCW too.
Yes.
I remember that was like early 2000s, wasn't it?
Yeah, but before I went to WCW, Vince Russo at the time, that was WWF at the time.
Yeah.
And he brought me over there. And when he jumped ship, I'm pretty loyal, so I just go, hey, he hired me for WWE. Before I
could
actually be on TV.
Yeah.
So I went to WCW.
Hey, you gotta be loyal to people who brought you in.
Yes.
Like, hey, you know, it's because if you show loyalty, like I do to my job, I work 6 days a week. Thank God I got today off.
Yeah.
My boss was like, you get it? I was like, I got a wrestling show that I referee too. And I'm doing interviews. Like, oh, you have a day off. I'm like, what? So yeah, loyalty can get you very, very far.
It's huge. Loyalty is huge.
And I noticed you work with Kevin a lot too, as well.
Yes.
Different signings and stuff like that, virtual and everything else.
Yes.
I met Kevin through Eric Bischoff. I interviewed Eric Bischoff on my show two years ago. I don't remember. It was years. You know how it is.
Years just clashed together.
Yes.
Like time just...
It's all mixed in. So before you all, thing you say the fans that's coming out here, the Heroes and Legends tonight. What do you say?
Hey guys, come out tonight because I'm only going to be here tonight.
Tonight? Tonight
just
only?
Just tonight only. It's the first time actually in
India. Oh, really?
Yeah.
So did you stay overnight? Or?
Yes, yeah.
What do you think about Fort Wayne?
You know, it's, the people are nice, actually.
Yeah.
You know, it's not... the people are nice. I like seeing grass trees. I'm big into... I do bonsai trees. So
oh, sweet.
I, So I do a lot of flowers and stuff as a hobby. So I like grasslands and, you know, and just farmlands.
Sweet. Thank you for watching Dos Landes. Stay tuned for some more interviews.
We're there. We're at the number one spot. Number one spot. Man, I'm sweating like bullets because things had to change. So, you guys ready for number one?
And the number one is?
And the number one out of the 50 drawing is going to be... Number one is, please say it's somebody new. I gotta redo that again. I gotta redo number one again. So they all kept falling out. And the number one is, who is number one? Number one is, oh, we already did that one. I guess I put that in there twice. Number one was a falsie. And the number one drawing for the celebrities on the show is, who is it? I'm sweaty, I'm nervous. Who is it? Number one is, ah, sweet. Number one is Johnny Fairplay. Johnny Fairplay is number one. That's crazy because Johnny Fairplay was our recent interview that we did with JJTV. Johnny Fairplay was on Survivor. And he's on TNA Impact Wrestling. And that's the... Yeah, so Johnny Fairplay is number one.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for tuning in to this edition of JJTV. If you found us on YouTube, please be sure to subscribe if you haven't already done so. If you are watching us on Facebook, like our page and tell all your friends. With a little help, we can reach a larger audience and make a bigger difference in our viewing community. Reality shows have captured the hearts of millions, but it's not every day an actor on several of them finds himself in Fort Wayne. And for what? Pinball. JJTV caught up with one of them and has a look at one of the biggest arcades in the world.
Sure, reality after show with Johnny Fairplay. We cover House of Villains, Survivor, The Challenge. If it's a great reality show, we're covering it. If it's not, I assure you we're not.
Johnny Fairplay is a reality show actor in town on a tour. He's also a professional wrestler and pinball enthusiast.
You'll see that I do love pinball at my house. At the time, I believe I had Godzilla and Deadpool. I now have a Star Wars.
Fairplay happened upon one of the biggest pinball arcades in the world over the weekend. Wizards World on Lima Road houses more than 100 different machines, and management is a huge fan.
The reason I brought Johnny in is he loves Survivor, he loves pinball. And I've been a fan of his all the time. You know, he's a game changer.
Mike Burgess is the owner at Wizards World. He started the arcade after he discovered a garage full of pinball machines was a real hit with his family. That was back in 2017 when he was looking for a place to hold competitions. Wizards World has since grown to be the only pinball-only arcade in the country. And he's actively promoting the attraction.
I've been big on promoting it with the kids. And big on promoting women's pinball. We're scheduled to have the Women's World Championship here in March.
You can watch Fair Play in House of Villains Thursday nights at 10 p.m. on E! Wizards World is located at 14601 Lima Road and is open to the public. Well, that's all the time we have today on JJTV. Please be sure to like and subscribe, post and share. We'll see you next time. I'm Joseph James.
So excited. My first week in Los Angeles in 2001,
high-end restaurant, took him to Dolphin Theater, and I was like, martini, chicken, I'll start going, actually, could I get a six on the beach? I was like, oh, my God, you, like, once you accept that role, that's your dream.
Yeah.
So that's why he's the first.
Years.